Hey everybody, welcome back. Today the topic is toothbrushes. Recently, Quip reached out to me and asked if they could send over one of their toothbrushes in exchange for an honest review. And since I had seen these toothbrushes advertised everywhere, and I was really curious about how it would stand up to my Sonicare, I went ahead and agreed and have been excitedly testing their product for the past like 2 to 2.5 weeks. To begin, I'll go ahead and show you what's in the contents of the bag that they sent me. I actually got the electric set, which means that it comes with a toothbrush, a full-size toothpaste, and a travel size toothpaste. So it arrives in a bag that looks just like this. And then the first thing you pull out is your toothbrush. I ended up surprising myself and ended up choosing the silver metal color. Typically I'm a gold girl, if you can't tell, but with this, I don't know, it just seemed more appealing and clean. So here you can see it comes in this slim portable case, and you just unscrew this. And you'll see that when you pull this out, it's actually sitting in another case. So what's interesting about this is that this little toothbrush holder itself goes onto your mirror, and it actually has this suction action that keeps it off of grimy, germy surfaces, so that when you're traveling from hotel room to hotel room, you can just suction it via this little strip in the back here that looks a whole lot like a sticky command strip. But what this is really doing is suctioning on your mirror, because when you peel it off, it leaves no sticky residue. It's actually really cool. So that is a really great feature and is what really makes this like a travel toothbrush, in my opinion, while not sacrificing any of the electronic benefits. That was a really, really nice feature. Now, the other two products that came in the box were these, and this is the full-size Quip toothpaste and then the travel Quip toothpaste. And each one has a recommended time period that you're supposed to use this product in. So for the full-size, it's every 3 months. And I bet you're thinking like, gosh, that's a really long time to have one tube of toothpaste. Well, something that this company also focuses on is their partnership with dentists and actually educating people on oral health. So on the back side of all of their tubes of toothpaste, you can see there's actually this recommendation that says pea-size guide. This tube should last you 3 months when brushing twice a day with a dentist recommended pea size portion of paste. That's not only to extend the life of the product, but also to make it optimal for what your mouth needs. So apparently you're not supposed to rinse your mouth out after you brush your teeth, which is something that I have to do every time, probably because I overuse toothpaste. This for me though, I will say, is not my favorite flavor. It's marketed as just mint, but to me, this was like sweet mint. So if you've ever tried that Orbit gum that's literally labeled sweet mint and it comes in the green packaging, that's what this tastes like. I like a more intense mint that leaves my breath feeling really fresh and like strong after I brush my teeth. This is just personal preference. It's a perfectly fine toothpaste. I just like something a little bit more like punchy. And then they also send over the travel size, which is supposed to last you approximately 2 weeks, assuming that you follow the pea size guidance. And this I haven't used because I haven't been traveling yet, but this is something that I definitely will use when I start traveling more this fall. This kit that I got is called the electric set, which means that every 3 months it will refill your brush head, a travel size toothpaste that lasts 2 weeks, and then the full size toothpaste that lasts 3 months. So that's if you get the electric set. The last thing that it came with were these manuals. This is just a basic manual on how to be a good oral care person. It also goes into details about their specific product. So it talks about the vibrating bristles, the portable design, and the soft heads, and then it goes into more of the portion guidance concerning the amount of toothpaste that you use. So as you can see, the normal bristles that you find on a toothbrush here are surrounded by these silicone bristles that sort of add this extra, I don't know, like it really just feels like it's getting your teeth cleaned. On the back, you can see that there's this little textured raised area. You can sort of see that. And it actually says Quip in it. And this is supposed to brush your tongue. So that's just one more way to have fresh breath throughout the day. To turn it on, all you do is just click this little cue. And you can hear it. It's actually a really quiet hum. And every 30 seconds, it will beep to alert you to go to a new quadrant of your mouth. So this technology is not new or groundbreaking. It's pretty much what you'll find in almost every electronic toothbrush on the market, but it is a nice feature to have so that people are actually brushing for the full 2 minutes. So that's pretty much all there is to this toothbrush. They even say on their site, it's no frills, no gimmicks. They're just trying to get your teeth clean in an efficient way. It's also really easy to travel with and to keep clean. What really sets Quip apart from most other electric toothbrush brands is the subscription style service. And you know me, I love a good subscription box. I love any kind of subscription service. I did a whole video on Billy, which is like a razor subscription. I do FabFitFun unboxings on my channel. I just really like that model. So every 3 months they get delivered to your door and you never have to think about it. You don't have to go to the store and pick it up. You can cancel, renew, stop at any time that you want. So that's the most appealing feature to me about Quip. Another really neat feature about Quip is that they give you a bunch of different buying options and price points. Quip sent me the electric set and I got a metal base. So one thing that you need to know across the board is that metal is more expensive than their plastic bases in every set that you can get. So the electric set that comes with the two different sizes of toothpaste plus the actual toothbrush costs you $40 up front. If you get the plastic base, it'll only cost you $25 up front. Every 3 months, you'll end up paying $10 to renew two different sizes of toothpaste plus the actual brush head that gets delivered to your door. So if you don't want the sets, they actually just have the electric brush options. If you get the electric brush with a metal base, that's gonna cost you $45 up front. And if you get the electric brush with a plastic base, it'll cost you $30 up front. Every 3 months after that, you'll pay $5 to get that replacement brush head sent to your door. So let's say you're somebody who doesn't want to pay monthly and you just want to pay everything up front. There's a plan for you too. So you can actually get the electric set, which comes with the two toothpaste and the toothbrush with a metal base for $65. And then your toothbrush heads will be sent to you every 3 months at no additional cost. But again, if you just want to leave off the toothpaste and you just want the brush head sent to you, but you want to pay everything up front, it'll cost you $55 up front if you want the toothbrush with the metal base. The group sets are also really neat. So let's say you're married and both you and your partner want Quip. You can actually get the electric couple set for $75. And if you are a family with four people, you can get the family set for $150. Do they have an option where you can go on their website and actually just purchase toothpaste or just a brush head because maybe you lost yours or something? Yes. So you can go on and you can buy a new toothbrush head that comes with a cover. You can buy toothpaste. You can buy this little plastic cup that sticks on your mirror if maybe you end up leaving this in a hotel room or something. They even have plastic regular toothbrushes, which is really weird. I don't know why they'd offer that since they're like an electric toothbrush company, but hey, they have that too. But if you have been an avid Sonicare fan like I have been for like the past decade of my life, I bet you're wondering what the similarities and differences are between the two toothbrushes. And that's why I've taken a little while to actually sit down and film this video, because I really wanted to accurately present the similarities and differences between the two. So let's start with the obvious differences, and that is the size. This is my Sonicare and this is Quip, and you can tell this is a great deal bigger. This also is not battery operated. It sits on a little charging port that charges on the bottom here. Now I have the Sonicare Flex Care Platinum, I believe, and I actually won this in a raffle at my dentist. And I'm really grateful that that's the case, because this actually retails for $199. Now I did look up the Sonicare price range, and it goes all the way down to $25, but all the way up to about $200 or more. So that's another obvious difference between the two toothbrushes, is that this one is way less expensive overall, not only in upfront cost, but also to maintain. If I want to go out and repurchase a brush head, you can typically find packs of two or three, but they're like $30 every time you go. So that could equal either $10 a brush head or $15 a brush head sometimes, depending on what's available in your store. But when all of these replacement brush heads are at $5, I mean, over time, this is obviously a more inexpensive product to have and use. Another difference that you could not point out just by looking at these is how they actually work. So first of all, the sound on this one and the sound on this one. This one is obviously way louder. Every Sonicare toothbrush is that loud. It's not just my style, but I've actually turned a lot of people on to this toothbrush because it's just like you left the dentist clean feeling every single time that you brush. Now, I heard the same thing from one of my friends that actually tried Quip, and they were like, my teeth have never felt this clean, but they had never used a Sonicare toothbrush or any other electric toothbrush for that matter. When comparing how my teeth feel after I brush, I do think this one does give you a little bit of a deeper clean. How you brush your teeth with this is that you don't do your traditional motion of back and forth. You actually just let this slowly glide over your teeth back and forth like this. So you're not like pulsing on your teeth when you brush. This one allows you to brush just like you would with a typical toothbrush. So it does have that sonic power going, but you're actually supposed to brush in a more traditional way. I tried just letting this glide over my teeth like I do with the Sonicare, and it definitely was not as an effective clean. So it's just the style of how you brush your teeth is a little bit different, and it's taken some adjusting to get me back to that mindset. Another difference between these is that this brush head is way bigger in my mouth than this one is. With Sonicare, you do actually have the option of a bunch of different types of brush heads. They just come in a bunch of different varieties and a bunch of different shapes. In contrast with Quip, you just have one option for your brush head. It's one type of bristle strength. It's one size all the way around. So that part is a little bit less customizable than it is with the Sonicare. Another thing is this one is just not as travel friendly. This is the travel case actually that I put my toothbrush in. All you do is you open this up, you take the two pieces apart, and then they fit nicely into their little holding spots, and then you close it. So when I hold these up side by side, you can really see that Quip takes up a lot less room than Sonicare does. Again, this is a more travel-friendly brand. They even have the thing that sticks onto the mirror, whereas this one you just have to set on a counter. It doesn't have any sort of option like that. So now that we've talked about the differences, let's touch on a little bit of the similarities. Now, one thing that they both have is an electric button to start and then a timer that beeps every 30 seconds, reminding you when to change quadrants in your mouth. That is one thing that is the same. The brush heads are replaced at the same time frame for both toothbrushes. This is changed every 3 months, and so is Quip. And then also, both of these are approved by the American Dental Association, so if you are as concerned about that as Kevin McAllister was in Home Alone,
is this toothbrush approved by the American Dental Association?
Then you should be all set. In the end, what would I say to you current Sonicare owners or those of you weighing, should you buy the Sonicare or the Quip? I'm going to go ahead and say that if you've never used an electric toothbrush before, go ahead and just get the Quip. It's cheaper overall up front, it's cheaper overall to maintain, and the difference that I feel in my mouth is very marginal after I brush my teeth. If you're somebody that has a Sonicare, do you need to go out and buy the Quip just because you like to travel? That's gonna have to be a personal decision. It's very clear that Quip takes up a lot less space, and overall, like the hygiene behind it, how it has the thing that sticks to the mirror and has a great travel case that's super small. I am very excited that I have one and I can travel with that toothbrush and leave behind the big bulky Sonicare. So hopefully this review was really helpful. Moral of the story is I really love Quip, and especially if you are new to the electric toothbrush game, or maybe you can't afford to maintain your Sonicare any longer, Quip is a great alternative. So I have been very pleased. I will continue to use the toothbrush, and thank you Quip for sending it my way. So if you have any more questions about the product, please leave those in the comments below. And if you like this video, then like it. And stick around, join the community, and subscribe. And I'll see you in my next one. Bye.